Hi everyone, welcome back to the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch course. This is part 4. We're still going through applications. In this video, we're going to look at charts. So as you can see, we're on the fourth part of this outline, this course outline. We're moving right through. Applications is the biggest section of this course, so we still got a good way to go. Let's get started and look at what charts can do for us. So we've got grids, we've got reports, and they're good for analyzing detailed data. But charts allow us to look at the big picture. So you're familiar with charts, they're nothing new, but they can be hard to make. They can be really hard to make if you're making them all by hand. So Scriptcase makes this really easy and allows us to customize charts a lot. So let's go over to our Scriptcase development environment and get started with building a couple charts. Okay, so here we are in the Scriptcase development environment in our reports folder. There's the PDF report that we created before. Let's go to new applications now. And we're going to choose a chart application. So that's one of our application types here. Just wait for this to load. And then we can choose from these, we can choose our chart application. So let me go find that, and there it is. So select that. And then we can select the table that we want to make a chart out of. So we're gonna select recordings here first. We're gonna create two charts in this video. So it named it automatically. There's the SQL select statement. Let's go ahead and click create on this now. And go ahead and wait for that to load, and we can start editing it. So click create, and then once that loads, we can select our fields, our metric fields that we want to include on this chart. So we have two different types of fields that we can include on a chart. So wait for this to load and you can see it. So we've got our dimension fields and our metric fields. So the dimension fields are going to be how we're restricting our data. And then metrics are going to be what we're measuring. So we're going to do quantity is what we're going to be measuring. And then we're going to measure quantity by media type. So media ID. So we're going to look at what the quantity is for MP3s or vinyl or CDs in our inventory. So let's go ahead and save this. And this should be ready to go, and we can go ahead and run it. And then once we run it, we can see a lot of customization that we have for this. But first, let's go to dimension fields and make sure our labeling is correct. So just like we've done on the grids and on the forms and on reports, we need to make sure that media shows a human readable value, such as the name from that, instead of just an integer. So as you can see, it's just an integer right now, and we're going to edit the lookup method, just like we've done on many of the other applications so far. So it's going to be an automatic method, and we're going to create a select that's going to look at the media table, and then the ID is going to be what's saved in the database, and the name is going to be shown on screen, and that's going to make it nice and human readable. So now we should be set up to go ahead and run this chart. So let's go ahead and click run on this and go ahead and wait for this to load. And here it is. Here is our chart. So very basic, just two different types here. As you can see, there's no values for MP3 because we don't have a quantity on hand for MP3 since it's not a physical inventory item. So let's go ahead and filter that out. So the way we do that is we can do that automatically with the SQL for the application. So let's go back to our chart application and edit it. We're going to go to the SQL section right here. Click on that and wait for that to load here. And we're going to modify that root SQL query here. Okay, so here it is. And then we can go ahead and add a where clause to this. So if you're familiar with SQL, this is easy. If not, you don't need to worry about this too much. We're just adding a where clause where the media ID field does not equal 2, since that is the ID for the MP3 media type. So let's go ahead and run this again now. And it should work and display only the values that we want. And get the load here. And here is our chart. And we can change this. There's a lot of different chart types. So we could switch to a pie chart, which might be a little bit more useful for this data. And there's a lot of different chart types, and we don't have time to explore them all. But you can have fun looking at them all and seeing which would be best for your purposes. So that is how you create charts in Scriptcase. So we're going to be using those a lot in a couple other applications as well.